What's up, divas? And what's up, divo? So you already know what time it is. It's Wednesday. It's your girl, April. We're about to do this real talk video. But before we do, let's get into some tea. What's been going on with me? What's been going on with y'all? What I got in the mail? What I'm drinking today? Y'all already know the deal with what I be drinking. It's the same shit all the time. A screwdriver. I know y'all probably like, is that what you really like, girl? Do you really like those vodka and oranges screwdriver? No, bitches. It's because that's all I know how to make, okay? I mean, I'm not a bartender. If I knew how to make some other drinks, trust me, I would be laid out, feet up like this because I done made me something special. So it's either that I drink on camera with you guys or I use this on camera with you guys. And I'm pretty sure that's not professional. Not like drinking is neither, but I really don't want to use my bong on camera. I just think that's a little bit too ghetto. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, I try to not promote getting high to folk. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's not too cool. But even though I'm a grown-ass woman, I'm not going to. Peer pressure is a motherfucker, like they say. It's peer pressure. It's peer pressure. So, yes, it's real talk now, Wednesday. And as y'all see, I got a new comforter. Not comforter. Excuse me, y'all already seen that. Well, the bed is not made that great today. But I got a new rug. I got that little furry rug. It's not little. It's cute size. It's a nice size. I got it for $20 at Wally World, Walmart. Yes, and I really like it. Let me tell y'all, I was about to spend $40 at Home Goods, which is TJ Maxx, and for the exact same size of the rug, okay? And I was like, you know what? I really don't. But the backing was a little bit different. You know, the backing was much harder. So it wasn't something that I could have put in the washing machine, my own washing machine. I probably would have to take it to a laundromat and put it in one of those humongous big washing machines. But in a washing machine at home that has a thing in the middle, it ain't fitting, okay? Especially because it was so stiff in the back. So I was like, how am I supposed to clean this? Okay, so when it gets dirty, I'm just going to throw it away because that's probably what I would have done. So I just was like, I talked myself out of purchasing it. And I actually had my daughter, Tati, help me too, which was a good thing because the very next freaking day, I seen that in Walmart for $20 in the rug section, y'all, in the rug section. So, yes, your girl purchased that. So, first of all, I just came home from the gym like 45 minutes ago. So, if I look a little well, you know, for me to be just coming from the gym, you know what I'm saying? My makeup is still on fleeky, fleek, fleek. I did touch it up a little bit. You know, I had to come on camera looking cute, okay? I had to come on camera looking cute. But for those of you who asked me to do a wrap tutorial on this particular hairstyle that I'm rocking, I will. I've already done it. I just have to edit the video. And some videos are more time consuming than others, like makeup videos. I hate editing those because they are so time consuming, but I will edit it this week. And this is just a half wig, and actually I have it on backwards because this is supposed to be the back and this is the front right there. But I had to put it on that way because the front was getting a little bit frizzy, kind of a little bit out of control. So I said, you know what? I'm about to just put this to the back and that be that. Okay. But yeah, this is just a half wig. I think it was, Moonwalk. I think that's what it's called, by Model Model. I'm not sure, but I did a video on it and I never wanted to wear it again. But it looks really cute like this. And yeah, so I have like a bunch of head wraps and stuff like that, you know, and I bought some yesterday from the 99 cents only store. So make sure you guys watch the video on that because I will be uploading a video on the 99 cents only store. Yes, I do have one. I just uploaded one. When you get this video, it'll be 2 days ago. It was on the Dollar Tree. Love the Dollar Tree. And I actually went back there today and bought a bunch of stuff. I'm going to stay out of the Dollar Tree because the whole concept is to spend a dollar. Well, really not, but they're very addicting and you can spend a lot. But anyway, first of all, I wanted to share something with you guys. I did get a package in the mail, and I'm so happy about that because it's from Quora. And if you guys don't know what Quora is, it is a monthly subscription to organic tampons. I know you guys are like, girl, please, we could just go to the grocery store or to Wally World and get some tampons and organic. What does it even matter? Well, a lot of people cannot use certain products inside of their vajayjay. So, but tampons and things like that are really kind of like, like not beneficial to them, because they can get all kind of venereal diseases or what have you, or not even venereal disease, excuse me. I mean, you know what I'm saying, like infections and stuff. And but Cora is also a really great foundation, because every monthly purchase that you purchase, a girl in a foreign country is able to benefit from getting womanly sanitary napkins. So this is the movement, to just be able to help out other young girls in other countries. And maybe here, I'm not really sure if it's here, but other young girls who cannot afford a lot of sanitary products. This is because the young lady who was the founder of this actually went to Kenya and met a young lady. And the young lady said she wasn't able to go to school certain times of the month because she couldn't afford sanitary pads. And it kind of like stuck with her, so she came out with Cora. But on the back, what got me was just the writing alone. It does describe what the tampons are about. Fearless Fit tampons, little black clutch, stowaways, and little black box. Now, first of all, I remember as a kid, as a young girl, like the age of 13 and 14. Well, 14 really, because I got my period when I was 14. I was so embarrassed to go to the store and buy some pads. Like, for real, I would come with my own bags, okay? You know what I'm saying? Like, I would come with extra bags to the store, to CVS, because I really didn't want anybody to see through the bag. I was so embarrassed. I just was ashamed. And I'm pretty sure I'm not the only one that was like that, you know what I'm saying? I would tuck me some extra plastic bags and go buy my pads. And back then, they weren't so, you know, sanitary. You know what I'm saying? They didn't have wings on them. And so, you know what I would do? I would actually take paper towels and wrap them around the panty crotch and then put the pad on, so that way nothing would get on the sides. And here they come out with fucking wings years later. You know what I'm saying? Like, damn. I was kind of like the inventor of that shit, but whatever. But yeah, I would go to the store and I would always carry an extra bag with me because I was so like embarrassed to have pads with me. And you know, a 16 count of pads, the box, the packaging wasn't like this big back then. It was like that fucking big. You know, when you have that slender packaging and shit, they were big pads. Them shits was diapers, okay? We was wearing diapers. Fuck the pads. We was wearing diapers. But anyway, you know what I'm saying? So I always bring my extra bags with me. I said bag, not bag. I said bags, plural. I would always bring my extra bags with me because, you know, CVS bags, you could see through them. And I would always go to CVS. Well, if you ask me today, do, you know, would you like a bag for this? Or bitch, please, I don't give a fuck about no bag for no tampons or pads. I will proudly say, yes, I got my motherfucking period and what, because at least I know I ain't having no baby. However, you need to have sex to have a baby and get pregnant. And I ain't had none of that in a long time. Though I am not missing out on nothing, because the last one that I had, well, shit. Let's be technical and really real about the shit. I was with old dude for like, what, he came, he moved here in October. October 2nd is when he came here. That's funny because it's the 4th. Which was almost a year ago. Which was a year ago. And his dick was so waxed. Oh, excuse me. Did I say that? So, the whole time I was with him, it was like I didn't have sex. So, you know. Anyway. But, yeah. If you ask me now, do I need a bag? Bitch, please. No, I don't need a motherfucking bag. I don't give a shit. I wish the motherfucker would say something to me about my pads and my period. I would let them know. Well, the best one to get is this one. And if you got a coupon, I ain't worried about that shit. I'm waiting for the day when I ain't got to buy that shit for myself anymore. I will be so fucking happy, okay? But yeah, so that's just one thing I remember as a young adult, just being so embarrassed to have to buy sanitary pads. And now it don't matter, like, you know, and I would tuck them away in my sleeve when I would have to go change. Now, you know what I'm saying? Now if I'm somewhere out in public and I got, what? Can I get, you got a pad? Oh, please. Tampon, it doesn't matter to me. I'm grown. But anyway, they described on the back everything about what's inside the box. But the thing that got my attention, and it was so like real, and I love the fact that they were so real, the way they described the little black box: stock your month's supply of tampons in your stylish storage container and leave it proudly on your vanity. You're a grown ass woman. Time to upgrade from the crumpled pink box under your sink. So you know what part already got me when they was like, you're a grown-ass woman. When I read that, I was like, oh, shit. Did they really write this on the sleeve of the advertisement card? That's what's up. I'm feeling them already. I like them. But they have a little black clutch. Your clutch is your daily companion during your period. Fill it up and drop it in your bag before braving the day, whether sitting on a conference table at the office or in your hand during cocktail hour. Our chic vegan leather clutch means no more tampons up your sleeves or rushing to pick up an emergency supplies from the corner store. So all of this just said everything about me, because I would put that shit up my sleeve and I've had to actually forgot them and had to go buy some at Walgreens. Stowaways, a tampon for sharing or an emergency stash. Give this to a friend and you'll both get a free month supply of tampons when she signs up. Fearless Fit Tampons. Our Fearless Fit Tampons are made of 100% premium organic cotton for form-fitting leak protection and purity. Our compact applicators are made of PBA-free plastic. And our soft touch wrappers are quiet and discreet. So some people do get kind of worried about that in a woman's bathroom. But here's the thing. If you're in a woman's bathroom, I don't know about you, but I'm not going to be discreet about pulling out a tampon and worried about the crumbling paper. Because y'all bitches in here for the same reason. Y'all either getting it now or y'all going to get it. Either way, or y'all done gotten it. But let me show y'all the box. First of all, it came, like I said, it's Cora. So if you purchase this on a monthly basis, just know that it helps out a young lady who cannot afford sanitary products. And I totally get it, because we take for granted a lot of the things that we get. So I totally get it. So welcome to the future of womanhood. Now, when I got this, I opened up the box, okay, while I was driving. I didn't know where it was from. I forgot the name of the company that contacted me. And I was like, ooh, what's this? I was like, ooh, what is this? This looks like little perfumes. You know what I'm saying? I was like, what's this? Y'all, first of all, y'all see the box, right? Banging. There was a bunch of these in there. And I opened this up. I was like, ooh, what is this? Is this candy? I still didn't know what it was. Then I started feeling, I was like, it's a tampon. So it got the R for regular on here. Is this like freaking genius or what? This is like so freaking like classy. I bet you Beyonce be using shit like this. You know, she looked like she would use something like this. Nothing but the best. You know what I'm saying? She be getting her little tampons on a monthly basis. And for y'all females out there who are like, oh no, she didn't talk about Beyonce. Yes, I freaking did. Okay. Get your little beehive and bzz, bzz, bzz elsewhere. But anyway, this is like, it just like so freaking cool. I love this. Like, it's black, it's chic. It does not look like a tampon. I wouldn't even be ashamed to find these in a garbage can. Okay? The clutch. Okay, magnetic. Okay, this is like too fucking cool. Excuse my language. But I'm loving it. You just put these in here. Well, of course, they can't be in this, okay? You have to take them out of this outside of the car, but I don't really want to take them out of this because this is just too cute. But you put them in here, like, isn't this cute? Like, and if somebody sees this on your table and they nosy and they want to open it up, oh, next time you should mind your business. But it came with that, and I think that is so cute. I think these are, like, the cutest thing ever. When they asked me what I would like to do about their tampons, I was like, okay, yeah, sure, whatever. They're freaking tampons. I can use some tampons. But I did not know it was going to look like this. So now I'm, like, totally, like, yes, tampons coming through. This is so chic. Okay, so this is the box that it has like this little ribbon right here, and you just open it up, and then oh my god, there's another box inside, and it's a box of like I don't know how many's in here, but premium organic 18 regular tampons. This is like so cute. This looks like something that would be at one of those little real ritzy fancy hotels, and you would want to. You would be happy to get your period because you would be like, girl, please, I got my period. What? Oh. And then all like the heavens and gods come out. It's the period gods, and they're like, oh. And then you open up this box and it's like, Cora, that monthly problem is now resolved. Banging, like I'm like loving it. And I also got an 18 box of Super. Thank God, because I was about to say, well, them regulars ain't gonna do shit for me, but we whatever. Okay, so yes, look at this is like so freaking posh. Like I'm feeling so ritzy right now, like totally ritzy right now, because I got like the jewel of the Nile when it comes to tampons. Like, seriously, like, this is so damn cool. And I know you guys are like, girl, they just tampons. It's the whole concept. First of all, I support anything that is a good cause, okay? But I love this packaging. This packaging is totally out of this world. And you can keep these. Like, you don't want to throw these out. You just take your little tampons, this little thing, and put them in here. You can carry it with you if you don't want to carry your compact little clip thing. I love this whole concept. So yes, you guys, Cora. So I will post it for you guys below. I thought this was a great concept and I'm really happy with this. I love little things like that. Whether you guys know it or not, I'm not bougie at all. Like, I have to tell you guys that. But I love the little things in life and I love supporting. Then I got this in the mail. I was like, what the freak is this? Is this a closure? Because it was so small. And it was from China. So obviously I didn't know where it was. So I was like, what the hell is this? You know what I'm saying? I don't know what this is. I didn't order anything. And I damn sure didn't order this. Then I was like, what the freak is this? It's like a headband. And then I was like, oh, these is panties. Okay. So I got some black panties. I could wear these with my new black tampons, right? Like, I don't know where this came from. But first of all, there's no freaking cotton at the crotch area. It's just lace, which is going to just kill me. And second of all, whose butt is fitting in here? Like, my ass ain't fitting in this. This is half of a fucking panty. Like, okay, really though? I don't know where it came from. I hope no company don't be like, well, did you get our review? You get our panty? We send you panties. You get it? You make a review on your panties. Like, bitch, please go sit down. Ain't nobody making no fucking video on no lace. That wasn't even a pair of panties. That was some fucking lace. So anyway, yes. That is all I had to basically talk about and let you guys know. I know I took up 16 minutes of your time, but y'all can get over it. Yes. So, also, I want to send some love to a couple of my subscribers. Because like I said last week, I love when you guys hit me up. It doesn't even have to be about real talk. You can just say hello. Hey, girl. What's up, bitch? Whatever. Let's skirt on that. Let's skirt. I would really prefer you not to be like in the email, what's up, bitch? Because I'll probably be like, what? I don't know who the fuck you think you're talking to, but I'm not your bitch. But you guys get the concept. I would love if you guys just say hello. You don't have to email me for just real talk. You can always say, hey, girl, what's up? I love you. You know, some shit like that. Bitch, you okay? You know what I'm saying? So I wanted to say what's up to my girl, K-Mia. And I think that's how you pronounce it. K-Mia. K-Lewis. I wanted to tell her what's up because, first of all, thank you so much for supporting my channel and showing your girl love. I appreciate it because if you guys watch me and take the time out of your busy schedules to watch me, then I appreciate it because you really didn't have to click on the video. And also, I have to say what's up to my girl, Carolyn Pritchard. Carolyn Pritchard. Carolyn. Okay? Now, I love it when ladies can tell me that they love the advice that I give because I'm 100. Because some people think that I have a potty mouth. And you know what I say to those people? Fuck you, because I really don't care. But Carolyn, she loves Sister Wigs. And I love Sister Wigs too because they have really great prices. And they're just really great people. And also, if you purchase from Sister Wigs, you can always have a 10% off code by using code MUFFIN. And also, if you have issues with Sister Wig, like if you didn't get your wig or whatever, send me an email with your order number. I would be more than happy to help you guys because that's what I'm here for. I have done it for many females before. And also, let's see. Trying to find. Well, her name on the email is Tarot Reader. Tarot Reader, okay? However, she said after she watched one of my videos, she went shopping for makeup for the first time in 2 years. That's what's up. And she also purchased the lipsticks from me. But girl, don't let me break your pockets, okay? Do not let me break your pockets because, girl, don't blame that shit on me. But she also says she likes to watch real talks while eating good fried catfish. I've never had catfish in my life, ever. I've never had it. Seasoned greens. with a good cold Pepsi. Okay, now shut the front door because I love greens and I love a good cold Pepsi. Pepsi is my favorite soda. That's the one I prefer the most. So I'm not really sure what her name is because she did not specify, but you know who you are. Your email address is Tarot Reader. So Tarot Reader 43. If you know that it's you, then of course, thank you for your email. I love getting emails from my girls because for one, it just lets me know that I'm loved just as much as I love you guys, and I appreciate all the love. So let's get on to this real talk because it's been 20 minutes in the making. So guys, if you have a real talk that you want me to do, send an email to me at muffinismylovers2012@gmail.com. Please put in the subject line real talk so that way I can get to you as soon as possible and I will know that it is a real talk video. All right. Hello, Miss April. I just wanted to say how much I love your videos and wig reviews. Thank you for making awesome YouTube videos. Why, thank you. You can call me Summer. Let me start from the beginning. I am a returning college student studying art at a university. I am so happy that I've made it this far because it's been 2 years since I went back to school. However, ever since I went back, it's been hard for me. I've been losing motivation to go to school and kind of distancing myself from my club activities. I'm apart at school. Mind you, I only have one class, so feel free, you give me all the side eye you want. I guess I'm just being lazy. My mom says it's because I haven't been to college in a while, so it's hard to get back in the groove of things. But I don't know. I had class today, and I decided not to go, and I was happy about it. Does that mean I should leave school? Am I making excuses? I've just been in a rut living in Oklahoma City. Although the college is great, I've just never really grown into this state. It's really hard for me to make good friends, socialize. I'm going to go to the doctor soon to seek help to see if it's anxiety or PMS. I don't know. I was so excited to go back to college, and now I don't feel right about it. I'm 23 years old, so I'm still new to being an adult and making my own decisions. I am in a volunteer organization group that allows me to travel to different countries to help people. I was thinking about doing that. Hopes to do something different. I just feel like I'm in a box all the time. What do you think I should do? Thank you so much. Love, Summer. Wow. So basically, Summer is 23. She hasn't been in school in 2 years. She just went back to college, and she only takes one class. And the girl ain't even trying to go to one class, okay? Because she just ain't feeling it. And her mom is saying basically that sometimes it's hard to get in the back of the group of things. And you know what? Your mom is right about that, Summer. Like, seriously, like with me, I haven't been to the gym and like years since this past month. You know, I've lost a few pounds. Forgot to tell you guys that, but yes, I have lost a few pounds. But I haven't been to the gym in like a few years, and I've lost my motivation with that. And let me tell you something. There are days when I really do not feel like going to that gym. Like, seriously, I don't feel like going to that gym. But I push myself because I know I have people that look up to me, or don't even look up to me, but I may be their motivation to lose weight as well, meaning you guys here. So I do it for you guys, and I also do it for me, but more or less I do it for you guys because I tell you what, I could stay my black ass at home and eat some goodies and be fine with that, but then I really wouldn't be fine with that because I don't want my body to look the way it is. But sometimes we lose our motivation for all types of reasons. You know what I'm saying? For all types of reasons. Me, it is hard to get back in the groove of things when you haven't done it in so long. And so I can definitely understand where you're coming from. However, if you're part of a volunteer program that allows you to travel to different countries and help people, then that's an awesome thing. You know what I'm saying? Because it's more or less like something that you can bank off of, meaning you can make money off of it. There are lots of groups, lots of people that do things like that for a living. I forget what they're called. But they more or less help people in third world countries and things like that. But you still do need some type of education for that as well. Whatever you're taking in school, you're taking art, I think you wrote, maybe it's not interesting to you. Maybe you need to find your knack, what you think is interesting to you. You're taking one class, it's really not a lot, but maybe that one class is just not grasping your attention. You know what I'm saying? Like, there are things that I have to do that I really don't want to do, like, which is working out. And let me tell you something. There are a lot of people that can put their headphones in and they could work out and rock out to music at the gym and just be okay with that. I'm not one of those people. You know what I'm saying? Like, I cannot put my headphones in and turn some music on and be rocking out to the gym. You know what I'm saying? And like, oh, yeah, on this treadmill and shit, it's elliptical and I'm working it out and I'm listening to whatever I'm listening to and I'm so fucking happy right now that I don't even know. I've only been on here for 5 minutes, which feels like 30, but I'm gonna keep rocking out. I'm not one of those people. I got to have my phone and my headset and I gotta watch Netflix. I have to watch some type of television show to allow me to focus on that television show instead of how long, bitch, have you been up on this fucking elliptical? Because you know you about to die any minute now, but it's only been 2 minutes and you got 28 more minutes to go, bitch. So, yes, my motivation is you guys, and also I'm able to be able to stay on that fucking elliptical for 30 minutes by watching The Walking Dead. Yes, The Walking Dead, okay? All right. So, yes, representing. So, a lot of things, a lot of people, it's all about a motivational thing. And if going to college is not grasping your attention, then why don't you look at it as this? It's only one class a day. You're lucky. One class a day, but it's art. And maybe it's not for you. Maybe it's not grasping your attention. Maybe you, per se, need to find something else to do that's more interesting to summer. You know what I'm saying? I'm not saying quit because I would never, ever want to tell anybody to quit something that could benefit them in life. But if you are in a volunteer program that you are able to go to other countries and help people, then why don't you try to find something in your school, your college, that is very similar to that, like human services, okay? It would be more or less like human services, you know what I'm saying? And if you like to help people, then that's a great thing, because I wanted to go to school for that, you know what I'm saying? My mom was always like, ah, don't do this, don't do that. But first, I wanted to be a designer, because y'all bitches don't know. A bitch, I could design some clothes. Like, I know how to sew, not in the fucking wigs, but I know how to sew and make clothes, okay? And that's what I used to do all in high school, make clothes and match book bags, and people would, and design certain kind of clothes, one leg off and one leg on in jeans, you know, crazy shit like that. I have to show y'all a picture. But I used to do all kind of crazy shit, you know what I'm saying? So I knew how to design shit, but my mom was like, you're never gonna make no money. But then I started feeling like I love helping people, so I decided I wanted to be a social worker. And even though I didn't get to be a social worker, I worked in the health insurance field. So I was senior VP for Medicaid health insurance. You know what I'm saying? I did that job for over 9.5 years, and I loved it. I loved being able to help those people, because those people were like me. We didn't have much money. You know what I'm saying? We just make it ends meet. And I love to help people that are like me. You know what I mean? But the people that I worked for pissed me off after a while. But maybe what you're doing and what you're going to school for, it just ain't you. You know what I'm saying? You got to pick something that you like. A lot of times we listen to a lot of people that's like, oh, you're not going to make no money. Don't pick that. Oh, you better go do this. Let me tell you something. A job is good. It's always nice to have a job. However, you got to find a job that you like, regardless if you're not making that much money at it. As long as it's something that you like doing, you know what I'm saying, or love doing, then it means more to you than just this. You know what I'm saying? A lot of us look at it like, you know what? I need to give me a job that's paying $25, $26 an hour, you know? And my job, I did make $25.69 an hour. That was getting paid good, and I got my bonuses and shit like that. But it wouldn't have really mattered to me because I enjoyed what I was doing. Now, you know what I'm saying? I don't work. What I do is I'm here. I have my own business and I run it and I love it. I enjoy making people feel beautiful. And I enjoy being able to give people a product for a significantly low price. That's what I like to do, because I know me. We see all these wigs on websites. They want $600 to $700 for these wigs that ain't even worth $2. You know what I'm saying? So what do? I give you a nice quality product for a cheap price because I'm a budget person. And me personally, I cannot afford a lot of things. But you know what? I make the best with what I have. And that's just what it is. But I always say you have to do what feels good for you. You cannot always live up to everybody else's expectations. You know what I'm saying? So if there's someone else that expected Summer to be an artist or to go to school for art, and that's not really what Summer likes to do, then Summer needs to do what makes Summer happy. You know what I'm saying? So I'm not saying quit and give up. You know what I'm saying? Because I would never want to tell anybody to stop doing something that's going to benefit them in life. However, what I'm telling you is you do something that makes you happy. You do it for you. You know what I'm saying? Regardless about what everybody else thinks, because at the end of the day, it's all about Summer. Summer is the one that's got to survive on her own, regardless of what anyone thinks. Summer is the one that got to make it through. And like I always say that to people, I don't really care what other people think about April. If that's how you think about me, I don't give a fuck, okay? And I say it just like that all the time. I don't give a fuck how you feel and think about me. That's just like with YouTube. I know there's a lot of people on YouTube that don't like me. They write dumb shit. Oh, I hate her. Old lady. Do you guys really think that I give two fucks, the deuce sign, two fucks about anybody disliking me? Like, I don't really give a shit. I don't care if nobody don't like me or can. It doesn't matter to me. You know what I'm saying? I have friends that were my friends and we not friends no more. And they write their little subliminal message. You think I give a fuck about them bitches? Hell no. Because they don't pay my bills. They don't take care of me. I got my kids here that love me regardless, unconditionally. So I don't really give a fuck if nobody don't like me. At the end of the day, whatever I do is for me and my children. It's to make me and my children happy and also for me and my children to survive. And the same thing goes for you, Summer. You have to do what makes you happy. Never feel like, oh my God, somebody is going to judge me because I didn't stay in school, or somebody's going to say something about me because I didn't stay in school. Who gives a shit? It's what Summer wants. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, it's what Summer wants and what makes her happy. And you know, with me, I always say life is too short, so you have to live that shit to the fullest. If what you want to do is help people in third world countries or whatever, then that's what the fuck you do. Regardless of what you do, someone is always going to have something to say. And what you do, that's a good thing. Going to help people in other countries, that's a blessing and a good thing. You know what I'm saying? Some people don't have the balls and the guts to go do that. Me, for one, I don't, because I'm scary. I'm not a scary person, but going places like that, it's like, okay, you know what? I'm a bitch like me gonna stay home, okay? But you have the balls and the guts to go out and do that. But dude, you're always gonna have somebody who's gonna say, oh, you shouldn't do that, girl. You're gonna get killed. You're gonna hurt yourself. You know what I'm saying? Somebody always got something to say. It don't matter if you fucking parted the sea and saved 100 people. Somebody always got something to say. So what I want to say to you is you do what's good for you. If it made you happy not to go to school that day, you have to think about that. When you do something that you don't like doing and you're forcing yourself into it, you're really not enjoying it. You're really not grasping anything from it. You're really not learning from it. So my advice to you is to pick a subject that will interest you. You will enjoy going that one day a week. Because I'm sorry, if you can't go to class one class a day, you only got to go once a day. You don't even want to go that one class a day. Then it's something about that class and that subject that's not interesting to you. And I'm not about to judge you, because I have been there. I have done many things in my life where I have picked up many tasks, many craft hobbies and shit like that. And I went through with them and I did it for a while. And then I stopped doing them. Like with my jewelry making, let me tell you something. I have in my garage, I have so much jewelry that from my website that I purchased, already made jewelry. And I have also so much jewelry supplies, rhinestones, beads. Like I have a storage container full that sits up this high. It's probably like that wide. It has multiple drawers all in it, multiple drawers. And then I have other things that has nothing but beads and all the materials that you would need to make jewelry. And what does it do? It sits there and collects dust because I'm not interested in it anymore. And I wish I knew somebody who was interested in it, because I would gladly fucking, we could either trade or we can work out some type of payment, you know what I'm saying, for a very low price. But yeah, I've done many things in my life where I've liked it for a minute, and then I just lost interest. And that's probably with you. And trust me, you ain't the only one, and you damn sure won't be the last. But I would suggest that you pick something that you enjoy doing that will make you want to go to that class. And if you don't have any interest in that class because it sounds like you don't, then maybe it's not for you. You know what I'm saying? It's just not for you. I'm not saying quit, but I'm saying try to find something that will help you further your education. Because we all want to be paid in life. Not meaning paid as in cha-ching, but paid as in cha-ching, but also paid as feeling like we are worthy of something. You know what I'm saying? And I would rather feel worthy of something than be basking in money. I mean, don't get it wrong, though. A bitch like money, okay? But I do like self-worth a whole lot more. I mean, I got a lot of my divas here who has shown me so much love. So Jennifer Lewis, I have to say hello to you. So she bought my lipstick as well, Mood On and Gemini. All right, diva. You liking them bright colors with Mood On. And Gemini, that's my favorite because you guys know I love neutrals. So I got to say thank you so much for purchasing my lipstick. I appreciate that. You guys don't know. I am a very humble person. Like, seriously, I appreciate anything. When people buy wigs from me, they're probably like, oh my God, why is she saying thank you so much? But I'm just like a really, really humble person. I appreciate anything that anybody does for me. You know what I'm saying? Because you just really don't understand. People go through a lot and just, I'm a really appreciative person. So next email. This one starts off kind of like a doozy. April, I am really hurting, and I think I chose the wrong people when I'm hurting. I met this guy at the dollar store, and he seemed nice. But within 5 minutes of meeting him, he lied. He had nothing going for himself. He is even deformed and walks with a limp. But he filled a deep, sick need, I guess. He told me I was beautiful. He said it was so much intensity. His intensity and passion for us fueled a, this girl is putting big words here. Veracuous, I think that says, I really can't, needed to, his intensity and passion fueled us to connect and be loved, okay? Oh, April, I have tears down my eyes at 4 o'clock in the morning crying about this foolishness. Aww. I wanted to believe him so bad. He said within 2 weeks he wanted to get married and he loved me. And he never felt this way before. He came on so thick and heavy I wasn't able to breathe or get to kick it as friends. I am so lonely for a relationship, but I am tired of hurting. I wanted that intensity to fill me up and take away this barbaric, insatiable need to be loved. I feel crazy, but I am not. I feel this painful place inside left by my cold mother to really be held, nurtured, and loved deeply. I used to fantasize as a little girl, play with my dolls in order to fill the gaping hole of being so lonely with a mother who was so emotional, unavailable. I needed to be held, touched, talked to, acknowledged, and included. But instead, I was ostracized, rejected, and constantly yelled at by a crazy woman who had no love to give. I felt consumed by my need for love. I felt so hurt, so hurt, so hurt, so hurt by her absence. She worked from 3 to 11 p.m., and when I did see her on the weekends, she fussed, cussed, and yelled. I felt so empty as an only child, isolated from the rest of the family. Her negligence and emotional abuse was unbearable. Today, I still seek men who remind me of my mother, and we reenact the same drama over and over again. My mother had an unusually close relationship with her mother, but that borderlined on emotional incest. My mother put her mother first. Have you ever heard of such a thing? She put her mother before herself, her husband, her children, and I ended up feeling so powerless in anger and full of rage. It's like her first love is her mother, but her worship of her mother is at the expense of her love for anything else. So today I find men who are in love with someone else and I fight to win this time. This time I'm going to win my mother's love by, I guess, subconsciously winning this guy from this woman he is obsessed. It hurts so much to love like this. I am compulsively drawn to cheaters. I am very attracted to them, then blame them for being who they are. I equated love with fantasy. I remember feeling so lonely. I started using fantasy like a drug. I would be in the room with no contact, loving connection or touch, and escape in fantasy where I saw myself loved and cared for by a man who would take all the pain away. Some people started using drugs and alcohol in their teenager years. I started to use love addiction and fantasy as a way to escape. The problem is that I find men who remind me of the pain from when I was a child. And I try to win their love or make them love me, and it always ends up in a disaster. The current guy is just as messed up as me. His mother gave him to the foster care system, and while he was there, he said the people used to stick brooms in his butt. Okay. He said he had never gotten over his mother giving him to the foster system while she kept the rest of her kids. He is 35 and homeless. One time he got a place, but it was filled with so many roaches I could not visit for fear I would carry roaches to my aunt's house where I was staying. I literally had to strip in the car down to bare essentials, keep my purse and makeup bag in the car so the hundreds of roaches, all ranging from babies to full-fledged adults, wouldn't travel on my person. April, we went to church and he had a Bible. When he opened the Bible in church, a roach crawled across Isaiah 31 in the middle of a sermon. Wow. He is in love with a whore named Deborah. Her Facebook timeline constantly talks about sex. Her last post said, "Absence makes the clit grow stronger." She slept with other men in the bed they shared as a couple, and other guys will call him and tell him about their sexual escapes with his woman. And his dumbass follows her like a nigga with his nose wide open. April, they went to a party, and she slept with him in front of his family and friends. His fam said, "Man, Deborah's in the bathroom screwing some dude." He stormed in the bathroom. She slapped him. He slapped her back. Yet this is who he wants? My ex of 9 years, who treated me like a queen, could say the same about me. He treated me like a queen, yet I settled for a broke man who makes $8 an hour, homeless, in love with another woman, deformed as he walks with a severe limp, ugly, no driver's license, an ex-felon, whoremonger, who lies, cheats, and manipulates. So I can't talk much. Obviously, all three of us have unresolved childhood trauma that makes us attracted to each other. My mother caused me so much pain with her emotional issues. I really despised her at one time, but now she's trying so hard to be in my life after I stopped speaking to her for 6 years. Love is painful to me. It feels like 1,000 nails in my heart. It makes me weak, stupid, and scared. When my heart opens, I am back to being a 9-year-old, stuck in a house with loneliness, despair, and emptiness. I felt so much despair, betrayal, pain, emptiness. Love means pain, shame, longing, yearning, despair, humiliation, and feelings of absolute powerlessness. I feel so much despair and anguish. Anger, a lot of anger, but also powerlessness. I would do anything to change the past, but even God can't change the past. I still feel anguish, pain, despair, and utter sadness and about me and my mom. So now that me and Joseph are over, I could grieve the pain I feel about him, or grieve the original pain that keeps me attracted to cheaters. Being attracted to a cheater is very painful. I know I like a one-woman man, but I am too overwhelmed from the pain of the past. I want to love without the trauma. Why on earth would I want a broke, lying, cheating, deformed dog? I cannot explain how much better I feel. I guess I just needed to talk it out. Usually, I keep things so bottled up and don't want to hurt others' feelings. I think today I will spend time writing out these old feelings, as I know I am hurting others with my unresolved hurt. Like I know he is hurting others with the memories of a broom up his butt. But April, these are deeply grooved patterns of relating and being. I just don't want to go back to the horrors and terror of the past in order to clean it up and be in the present and normal. April, my mother is trying so hard to be a good mother. She is 67 years old now and sends me money and text messages. Anyway, thank you so much for providing a place to release. I just never talk about things that bother me. And I saw you on YouTube and I decided I needed to talk about it. I don't care what you do with this email. You can read it on air, dismiss it, write back, or just pray for me. But truthfully, I feel so much better. It's unbelievable how getting shit out helps. If you choose to read this on air, my question would be, do you think I should let my mother back in my life? After all, her years of emotional abuse, and what do you think about Joseph, me, and the whore? Thank you so much for providing the space to speak my pain. Who would have ever thought I would get healing from writing a popular YouTuber? God bless. Wow. I'm going to just take a drink for that real quick. Gigi. Okay, that was a lot. And from what I've read, this person is going through a lot. And you know what? I remember watching these shows back when Maury Povich wasn't doing fucking DNA tests all the time for fucking bitches who don't know who their baby daddy is. Oh my God. I did not know he was not the father. Then they throw themselves on the floor and dumb shit. You know, he's a spokesperson for bitches who don't know who their baby daddy is. Whatever. But I used to really like Maury until those days. And I would see people on there basically, and they would say things like their mother did this to them or their mother didn't pay them no attention. And it would just really scar these people. And they would be like in their 40s. And it's like, okay, bitch, you was like 10. That's 30 years ago. So you're saying that the shit that you do today is because of what the fuck happened to you when you was 10 years old? Your mother didn't pay you no attention or she beat you? Sorry about that. So my memory card got full. So like I was saying, like, get the fuck over it. Let me make sure my microphone is still on. Yes. Okay. Like, really, like, get the fuck over it. Like, oh God, like, I understand we all go through some shit in life. It could be a whole lot of shit, but I'm sorry, I'm not gonna let my shit from 10 and 12 and 13 fuck up my life at 42. Like, okay, listen, I love my mom to death, but she was not the best mom in the world. You guys think that some people think like, oh, when we get on here, we have the best of life. Let me tell you something. I have had child protection come to my house many a times when I was a kid, okay? You know, a few times I went to school with welt marks because my mom beat me. Like, she would say mean things to me. My mom would say things to me. And I'll never forget, this stuck in my head, and it's still, and I'm 42. When I was 14, I look better than you. Who tells her kid that they look better than them? Well, I'm 14. How old are you? You're 20 years older than me. Okay, so you're 34. Why are you comparing yourself to me and I'm a teenager? You shouldn't even be comparing yourself to me in general. But she would say things. My mom would say all kind of little things. I'm a whore. I'm a bitch. All kind of little things. She would do all kind of little things to me. But you know what? I never allowed it to affect who I am or who I became in life. You know what I'm saying? So I really don't understand why people allow shit like that. And I know some things are just so traumatic, but you know what? I don't let that hinder me from being and doing what the fuck I need to do in life. Like, for real. Some people are just like thrive on that shit. Like, they get up there, hey, man, man. Like, okay, you know what, Gigi? Get over the shit. Get the fuck over it. You're talking about he's a whoremonger, he's crippled. First of all, let's not make fun of the fact that he works with a limp and he's crippled. Who gives a fuck about that part? Because you're basically saying, oh, well, you like him and he's crippled. So what, bitch? You stupid, okay? And I'm not trying to be mean to you. Yeah, get your emotions out, but let's just get this in. Okay, he's homeless. Maybe you can help him not be fucking homeless. He makes $8 an hour. At least that motherfucker has a job, bitch. Okay, and he has he's crippled. He has a handicap. So fucking what? All right. Who doesn't have a handicap? Let's not say, oh, I don't want to be with nobody because they walk with a limp. Because who are you to specify or say that? Oh, I don't want to be with somebody because they crippled. Like, who the fuck is you? Obviously, you have some issues of your own. And they don't all stare down to your mom. And I'm glad that you wrote me and you could get this off your chest, because I'm going to get this off my chest to your ass. Now, you with a whoremonger. Whoremonger is a very harsh word to call him. However, if he is with somebody that he truly cares about, regardless of the shit that they went through, that's his business. Leave it to him. You know what I'm saying? Let him do him. However, maybe you should get your shit straight. What I think would be really great for you, because you have so much built up animosity towards your mom and anger, that you need to really get down into the deep levels of that shit. Like, reach and pull out your motherfucking soul and get into that shit, because if you don't, that shit is going to eat you alive. And now, okay, so your mom sends you money and she texts you, but you're asking me, should you allow her back in your life? Bitch, if you're accepting money from her and text messages, why wouldn't you? Yes, we all make mistakes. There's no book for being good parents, okay? I'm never gonna sit here and tell you that I am the best parent in the world, because there have been been many times when I have said many mean things to my kids, okay? Not knowing that it would hurt their feelings like that, but they have brought this up to me on many occasions, and I have apologized for what I have done to them. So there's no great book on parenting, but you also are complaining that your mom worked 3 to 11 p.m. Maybe that was the only job that she could get at the time, and that was what she could take to be able to afford a roof over your head, so... Excuse me. I don't know why you're complaining about that, because at least she had a fucking job. Some women don't even have jobs for their kids, and their kids go without. So because your mom worked 3 to 11, what? Because she wasn't there to take you off the school bus or whatever? Let me tell you something. Sometimes we have to sacrifice a lot in order for our children to be able to have something in life. You know what I'm saying? Like, I sacrifice a lot myself because I'm constantly sitting down making wigs. I'm constantly sitting down doing videos because I need to make sure that my kids have a roof over their head. So I'm sacrificing time with my children. You know what I'm saying? So I wouldn't really complain about that. However, what I would complain about is your self-esteem. It seems like you really don't have any. If you thrive off of men who cheat and such and do things like that, then maybe it's you that needs to take the look at what's really going on. You know what I'm saying? Not the men in general, but you as a person. You know what I'm saying? You as a person. Let's not talk about anybody's handicap. Let's not talk about anybody who can't afford to take care of themselves, meaning they're homeless and they make $8,000 an hour. I give him credit because he's handicapped and he has a fucking job. People that are not handicapped, that got two good legs, ain't got a fucking pot to piss in or a job, and lazy and don't want to do shit with their life. So what are we to say about those motherfuckers? So yeah, you like people that cheat. It's you that needs the evaluation. It's you that needs to think and rethink about, what does Gigi want to do with herself? Maybe she needs to get it together and stop fucking with these people that ain't about shit. Okay? You know what I'm saying? Let's not critique and criticize them. And as for you wanting to be friends and be back with your mom, should you? You know what? If we allow shit in our past to keep on, if we allow to keep being hateful towards these people, it's gonna eat you alive. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes you have to learn to forgive and forget. And though it may be hard for a lot of us for certain things, certain times and certain things in life, you need to learn how to forgive and forget, especially when it comes to your parent. Now, your mother wasn't raping you. She wasn't doing any of that. She just was kind of harsh and she worked. Okay, she didn't molest you. She didn't give you the man to molest you. She didn't do any of that. She didn't prostitute you. She worked from 3 to 11. She yelled at you or whatever, whatever. You know what I'm saying? Okay, who hasn't gone through that in life? Me, I've gone through enough. You know what I'm saying? I could sit here and write a book and tell you guys for hours and hours of the shit that I went through in my life, and you would be like, damn, girl. You know what I'm saying? And not with just my mom, but with other family members. You know what I'm saying? Shit that I remember to this day, and I didn't allow it to scar me. You know what I'm saying? I did not allow it to scar me. However, there is a time and a place when you need to learn to forgive. It's called forgiveness. You know what I'm saying? You can't allow shit to keep eating you up and being hateful towards somebody, because misery loves company. And let me tell you something. It takes a whole lot more energy to be mean and hateful and mad at somebody than it does to just be a good, humble person. You know what I'm saying? Like, I used to go around and be mean, not mean to everybody, but have this attitude, this funky attitude. And it was probably because I was bullied a lot as a kid. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, you guys probably, like, you was bullied. I was bullied a lot. Called names, freckle face, pissy yellow, you Medusa, shit like that. People would bully me a lot up until high school and do all kind of things to me. Make fun of the sneakers that I wore because it had 4 stripes on it instead of 3. My mom was poor. We didn't have nothing. I did not get a pair of Nikes until I was 15 years old. You know what I'm saying? I wore freaking sneakers that were no name brand, balloons. But that's what my mom could afford, and I was happy with that. You know what I'm saying? I was happy with that. But I was bullied, and I'll never forget the day this girl in fucking 9th grade, this bitch, she fucking threw spit bubbles at me through a straw, and I ignored it for like a couple of minutes, and then she kept doing it. Let me tell y'all something. I walked out of that classroom, and I went upstairs, and I got my cousin, and then we came downstairs, and I beat the shit out of her, okay? That was the first fight I ever had, and after that day, I was like, you know what? I'm not being nice to nobody. I'm tired of shit, And from the ninth grade on until adulthood, I was a bitch to every fucking body. I don't take no shit. I don't tolerate nothing. My attitude would be like, fuck you, and fuck you. And somewhat today, I'm still like that, you know what I'm saying? Because I don't let nobody walk all over me, and I damn sure ain't about to tolerate nobody's bullshit, you know what I'm saying? So I am somewhat like that because I was bullied a lot as a kid, and you know, I grew up in the projects, and we didn't have much. And I'm not gonna sit here in front and act like, oh, I got it all today. Let me tell you something. I go to Walmart, I go to the gym, and I have two pairs of sneakers in my closet. You know what I'm saying? I have a pair of Huarache Nikes that I've had for probably like 9 years, because I really don't wear sneakers. And I got me a pair of, they my sneakers, and I don't give a fuck what nobody say. They are some sneakers I got from Walmart that I work out in at the gym, and they are comfortable as ever. You know what I'm saying? So people might sit here and think, oh, bitch, you got this and you got that. No, bitches, y'all don't really know the shit and the struggle that I go through on an everyday basis. The reason why my shit look like this is because I can refurbish, and I'm handy with tools and paint, and I can do my shit over. This dresser right here is 10 years old. My daughter is 9. I had this dresser since I was pregnant with Mumsy. It's knock on wood. It's real sturdy wood, and I painted it twice, okay? And I've had it since then, okay, for 10 years, okay? Who the hell has furniture for 10 years? I've had that dresser for 10 years. I've had the fucking dresser over there for 10 years. You guys can't even see it, but you get the drift. Like, I've had shit in my room for 10 years. That mattress on my bed I've had for fucking 9 years. Like, come on, you know what I'm saying? So I know the struggle, and I've been bullied, and I go through a lot, but I don't take no shit from nobody, and I don't let the shit in my past get to me today and allow me and fucking disable me from doing the shit that I need to do, you know what I'm saying? So Gigi, get your shit together, because it's not really the people that you are thriving to, it's you in general. That's your mom, you know what I'm saying? We all gotta go through some shit in life, because if we didn't, it wouldn't be called fucking life. People don't realize that. I tell that to my kids all the time. They be like, oh, I'm tired of going through this. I'm tired of doing this. I'm kind of going through this. And I have to tell them, you know what? It's part of life. Oh, it's all, everybody says it's a part of life. Look at the word life. You think that if it was life, it would be smooth sailing all the time, and you would be able to just glide through that shit? Then that wouldn't be fucking life. That would be a motherfucking fantasy, like you living in Gigi, a motherfucking fantasy. All right? It wouldn't be no real shit. It's a part of life. It's a stair step. Yeah, we got those people that is born with a silver spoon in their mouth, and they get to do what the fuck ever they want, and they get to glide through, but them motherfuckers still got a heart. Or you put them out in the real world, them bitches wouldn't know what the fuck to do, okay? You know what I'm saying? So it's bitches and motherfuckers like you and me who've already been through the shit, the struggle and the hassle, and we know what to expect, and we know how to survive. And for you, Gigi, you should know better, okay? Yeah, motherfuckers, they cheat, but don't be attracted to them shit. Don't attract them. You're not going to be able to change them. You're not going to be able to change them. They a cheater, they always a cheater. You're not going to be able to change them. So you know what you do? You mind your motherfucking business and go about your business. First of all, you don't even need to be in a relationship, because you're so thriving on being with motherfuckers that cheat and shit. Maybe it's time for you to find yourself, because it seems like you got a whole lot of built up bullshit inside that's going on that you don't know nothing about. You know what I'm saying? That's your mama. She might have did some fucked up shit in life. Me as well. I did some fucked up shit in life to my kids as well. You know what I'm saying? With my mouth and the things that I've said. But you know what? At the end of the day, that's my kids and I'm their mother. And regardless of what, you have to learn to forgive and forget. Point blank, period. So on that note, let Gigi know your thoughts and feelings on that, as well as Summer. And you guys already know, I will see you in a soon-to-come video. Make sure you check out my Dollar Tree haul, y'all. And check out my freaking Kylie Jenner $2 lip kit. Tati is in that video with me. Oh, I am so mad about that video, y'all. First of all, I tried the LA Girl Pro HD Setting Powder, that white shit translucent. Fucked up my whole makeup. For real, dude. Fucked up my whole makeup. So on that note, stay diva and divalicious. I love you guys, and I'll see you soon.